Hello everyone, welcome to this third video of Calculus of Variation. And we are using this COV for this Calculus of Variation as short form. So what is Calculus of Variation? We know this is a study of problems of maxima and minima of functionals. Problems of finding maxima and minima of functionals. And what is a functional? A functional is a function of functions. It means that we have a domain as functions, domain as set of functions. We are inputting a function in the functional to obtain some real or complex number. So first of all, we need to know what type of functionals we'll deal with. We have seen that in the last video, we have seen that when you have these two points A and B in the plane and there is some curve joining these two points, suppose this is my B, y of x, then the length of the curve from the point A to B is given by this 1 plus y dash square dx integration from the point A to B. And what we wanted to know is we want to find out a function y of x such that this value is minimum. So basically we want to find out a curve joining the points A and B along which the distance between these two points is minimum. So we have this kind of functional, right? This kind of functional is called a local functional. This functional is called a local functional. So what is the definition of, what is the formal definition of local functional? A local functional is basically, it is a functional, I'll explain it like this. Suppose you have this curve y of x, right? And I want to find out the length of this curve. This is my point A, capital A, sorry. This is my point capital B. So I can do it like this. I can divide this curve into many parts, okay? And now I can find the length of this part, length of this part, length of this part, and so on. And I can add all these parts to obtain the final length. Okay. So this functional is actually this functional. This is what is this? This is the length. So I can write it like this. Suppose this point is A, this point is x1, this point is x2, and so on. This last point is xn. Then I have this point B. Okay, corresponding to this, then I can actually, instead of finding this j of y like this, I can find it like this. J of y is a to x1 f x y y dash dx plus x1 to x2 f x y y dash dx plus so on, and the last part is xn to b f x y y dash dx. Okay, so basically a functional which can be computed by dividing this curve yx into different parts just by adding, this functional is called a local functional. Okay, all the functional may not be of this type. Okay, let us first write down the definition of a local functional. If we divide the curve yx into parts and calculate the value of the functional for each part, the sum of the value of the functional for the separate parts equal to the value of the functional for the whole curve. Let me write it down so that it is more clear. If we divide the curve yx into parts and calculate the value of the functional for each part, for each part, the sum of the values of the functional for the separate parts, the sum of the values of the functionals, values of the functional for separate parts should be equal to the value of the functional for whole curve yx. This is the definition. If this happens, then your functional is a local functional. Okay. So if there is a local functional, now we are studying, there is something called local functional, then there has to be something called non-local functional. Let us see what is a non-local functional. Okay, what is a non-local functional? Okay, a functional which is not local, a functional which is not local is called a non-local functional. I'll give you an example. Consider this functional. Consider this example, j of y is equal to a to b x 1 plus y dash square dx upon a to b 1 plus y dash square dx. Physically, what it is representing is, suppose you have this curve y of x, okay? There will be some center of mass of this curve. What is the center of mass? Like if this this is some material, okay? This is something which is made up of some material having some mass. So basically, we are looking for a point where we can the whole of the mass of this part of this thing, whatever it can be, any material, is concentrated. We are looking for the x coordinate and y coordinate of a point which is called the center of mass, where the whole of the mass of this curve can be assumed to be concentrated. Okay, so basically this is actually the abscissa of center of mass of the curve y of x. This is the abscissa of center of mass. Okay, and you can obviously, it is clear that I can't do like this, that I'll compute the center of mass of this part. I compute the center of mass, abscissa of center of mass of this part, abscissa of center of mass of this part, abscissa of center of mass of this part. And if I'll add all the abscissas, I will not get the abscissa of center of mass of this whole thing, right? So this is an example of the functional which is actually non-local. Okay, so it is like this. Study of non-local functionals is a little difficult as compared to local functionals. So whatever we are now going to do is, first of all, we will establish a theory for local functionals. Okay, what theory we have to establish? So basically, I have a functional j of y. I can write it, and it is local. So local is like this. I will always write it like this: x, y, y dash, y double dash, and so on. And n derivatives can be involved. So this is how we can denote a local functional. So I have a local functional, and I want to find out y. Okay, you can see that what I am doing is, this is a number. This is a number. So basically, I have a machine where I am inputting a function. This y is a function. I'm taking some y from a function space. What is a function space? We will look at that. I have a space from where I am picking the values of the functions, and I'm putting in this machine j, and I'm getting a number out. And I want to find out a y for which this number is actually a maximum or minimum value which this g of y can attain, right? So I have to establish a theory. I want to know how I can actually find that. That we will do in next video. Thank you.